Welcome and thank you for enrolling in the Oracle JavaScript Extension Toolkit's massive open online course. Yes, that's a really long name. We'll just call it Oracle JET MOOC going forward, and we will often be using the term JET instead of Oracle JET. During the next 3 weeks, you'll be taken through a wide range of technologies, concepts, and best practices that make up JET. Before you get started, though, we want to provide some helpful tips and insights, a look into the resources that will be available during the course, as well as set some expectations about how the course is laid out and delivered. Let's start off by saying what this course is not. This course is about Oracle JET, the JavaScript Extension Toolkit, not about JavaScript itself, not about the JavaScript language, and not about the JavaScript ecosystem. You are encouraged to explore the JavaScript language and ecosystem and related tools and technologies to get familiar with them before getting started with the course. Basic JavaScript knowledge should be all that is required, though you may find yourself needing to do some research now and then to understand some of the syntax used, depending on your level of JavaScript knowledge. We have found that quite a few developers have been able to learn JavaScript at the same time as learning Oracle JET. Next, let's look at how the course is delivered and how you can get the most out of it. There will be 10 parts to each of the 3 weekly lessons. These parts will include a short video of no more than about 10 minutes in length. These videos provide you with an overview of the topic for that part and lead you in a proper direction for performing the homework that will be assigned at the end of most parts as well. To get the most out of each topic, you will need to spend as much time as you need to work on that homework task. At the end of each week, there's a quiz with 10 questions. The answers to all of the questions are covered in the videos and homework that you have watched and worked on during the week. Each of the 3 weeks will provide a different look at how JET is put together. Each part of the 3 weekly lessons will be delivered in a similar way. What you'll need to do to get the most out of each week will vary from week to week. In the first week, you're going to look at some of the underlying technologies that JET uses, and a lot of the homework tasks will be reviewing websites, as well as writing some basic code that uses those technologies in the context of a simple JET application. In the second week, the focus is on JET features themselves: UI components, theming, layout, routing, validators, etc. Pretty much all of the things that you will use to actually build the user interface of your application. Homework for this week may seem light at first, but you should explore and try different aspects of the topic on your own. Be creative, try new things. It's this time of exploration that will help you get the most out of the different topics. The third week we'll review more of the framework type topics. These include things like security, testing, packaging, connecting your application to Oracle Cloud Services, integrating third-party UI components, and the very important topic of the Composite Component Architecture, known as CCA, or the Web Component Approach that JET takes. Homework for this week can be quite involved. It may take more time to set up and configure external services and features to get the Oracle JET app that you've written connected to that service, feature, or technology. So be prepared to spend a little more time on the homework in the final week. Obviously, you're not going to get in-depth step-by-step instructions from a short 10-minute video. Look to those videos as starting points and the homework as the area where you want to explore and learn the most from. To help with your exploration of Oracle JET during the coming 3 weeks, we have a discussion forum for all students to join and interact with each other. Think of this as the virtual classroom for this MOOC. When using the discussion group, please add the tag MOOC to all your questions. This will make it very easy for fellow students to see related questions, as well as possible answers to similar questions that they may have. Please get involved with the discussion group. Answer questions as well as ask them if you know the answers. It's not only a great chance to learn about JET, but also a chance to meet others that are sharing the same journey. So get involved. In a similar way, please use Twitter to share your new learnings and insights. When you add the Oracle JET Twitter handle to your tweets, you'll find that you'll get retweeted very quickly, so that knowledge about JET can be shared, and so that others in the community can find out about the activity that is taking place around the JET MOOC. Please don't be shy. Send out a tweet with the Oracle JET Twitter handle and let the world know about the interesting new things you're learning about. Also, please note that whenever you need to find the links to the developer's guide, the cookbook, the discussion forums, the blogs, just remember oraclejet.org. That one URL provides you with all the links to everything you need. Oraclejet.org is where it all begins. Some of you may have completed the previous version of the JET MOOC. Is there a reason to take the MOOC again, and what are the key differences? We have tried to keep the MOOC as similar to the previous version as possible. We have not redesigned it. Instead, we have updated it with new content. In particular, the new custom element syntax has had an impact on the demos, while also the increased relevance of web components via the composite component architecture is addressed too in the third week. If we were to redesign the MOOC as a whole, we would place a far stronger focus on the composite component architecture, and we may do that in future. Another new feature is the Oracle JET command line interface, which we will be using throughout the MOOC. In short, the differences compared to the previous MOOC are not on the conceptual level. While the syntax is different, the CCA components have a greater prominence and the command line interface has been added. The first week is also structured differently, in that you start off with an Oracle JET application and learn about technologies like require and knockout in the context of that JET application. To conclude this point, you are more than welcome to take the MOOC a second time to update yourself on these points and to refresh your knowledge. What do you need to install and set up in order to do the Oracle JET MOOC? You are assumed to have installed the Oracle JET command line interface and to have created your first Oracle JET application before the MOOC begins in part one of the first week. Therefore, before starting the MOOC, go to the Oracle JET Get Started page to set up your environment. Use any editor that supports JavaScript, HTML, and CSS. And note that we recommend NetBeans IDE because it has great support for JavaScript. It lets you open JET applications based on the fact that they contain a package.json file. And also because NetBeans has terminal integration, meaning that you can run the command line directly from inside NetBeans. Also make sure to use the facilities provided by your browser, such as the Chrome Developer Tools in Chrome, for debugging purposes. Okay, let's get started. Go into the browser, put in there oraclejet.org, press enter. You will be redirected to this location. You will find yourself on the homepage of Oracle JET. Click the Get Started button, and here are all the instructions you need for setting up your first JET application. Begin by, if you have not set up Node, setting up Node, following this link here. Once you've done that, you will have npm. And so then on the command line, you will type npm minus g for global, and you'll install the Oracle JET command line interface. Once this instruction is completed, you will have the OJET utility available. And in the same way as you typed npm before on the command prompt, you will now type OJET followed by the word curate, and then the name of a project, whatever name you like, my app, my demo, my amazing application, as one word, without spaces, followed by dash dash template equals, and then one of the templates. So these pipe symbols mean these are different templates, one of which you must choose. So you would type dash dash template equals, and we will start with nav drawer in the course. During the first week, there will be one part dedicated specifically to the Oracle JET command line interface. But for the moment, all you need to know is this: OJET curate and the name of a project, and then dash dash template equals nav drawer, press enter, and your application will be curated. You will then cd into that folder that's been curated, and you will run OJET serve, and you will see an application opening in your browser. Once you have set everything up, within 2 minutes, you should have your application curated for you without any problems. All right, we can see that we have the Oracle JET command line interface installed, because when we type urjet dash dash help, a range of commands are shown. Now, these commands we're going to look at throughout the course. For the moment, in order to prepare for the first part of the course, we need to set up an application. So we type urjet and then create, which is one of the commands on the Oracle JET command line interface, and then the name of our project, and we will call it my app in this case. You can name it whatever you like. And we add in here template is, and then the name of a template, nav drawer, and we press enter. And now the Oracle JET command line interface is going to use npm under the hood, your node package manager, to pull down all the JavaScript libraries that we need to construct an Oracle JET application. And at the end of this process, we're going to have our first Oracle JET application generated for us. And we can see at the end of this process, all the different libraries that are part of this project. And then we CD into it. We go into CD my app. And then we can explore that structure as we will do throughout the course. And just to check that everything is okay, we type urjet serve and the application will be served up into the browser. And here we have, within 2 minutes, the starting point of our first Oracle JET application. Finally, please take your time. It's not a competition. Don't go too fast. Go slowly and carefully and thoroughly through each part of each lesson. Do your homework tasks. Work through the Oracle JET cookbook and the developer guide using the references that you will be provided throughout the MOOC. And try and apply the concepts to the business requirements that you can expect to have in the context in which you're working. Thanks again for enrolling in the Oracle JET MOOC. We hope you enjoy your time exploring and learning about Oracle JET, the JavaScript extension toolkit.